Hi everybody, I'm Ryuji Sakakibara from Toho University, Sakura, Japan. My topic is possible premotor MSA cerebellar form. Synucleinopathy triangle, so-called, it includes motor disorder, as you can see, Parkinsonian or cerebellar. Cognitive mental disorder is not common in MSA. And also, of course, autonomic sleep disorder. Sakura autonomic disorder in rats. Bladder dysfunction in Sunka alpha-synuclein transgenic mouse model of MSA clearly includes Sakura intermediate lateral nucleus involvement, as you can see. So how about in patients? Sakura autonomic disorder in MSA. Up to 80.2%, up to a period of 7 years, MSA patients may have bladder dysfunction at all. And this is a study by Dr. Panicker. 6 cases of MSA presented with bladder dysfunction at all, further developing full clinical manifestation. 1 autopsy verified. So, is it possible to diagnose such an early premotor MSA in situ? MSA is a progressive degenerative disorder, clinically defined as combination of motor, Parkinsonian cerebellar, and autonomic disease disorders by the second consensus statement on the diagnosis of MSA. In contrast, recent prospective cohort studies have shown that up to 18.2% of MSA patients start with bladder dysfunction alone, suggesting that disorder disease process of alpha-synuclein aggregation might begin in the sacral spinal cord. However, a question arises as to whether we are able to diagnose such very early premotor MSA in situ. Study design is, this is a case report. A 52 years old, previous healthy Japanese man with no family history gradually developed difficult urination and large PBR possible residuals and daytime urinary frequency. A local urologist was taking care of him, and this patient showed an OABSS, it's a questionnaire, 1 in 15, and the IPSS, 10 in 35, indicating difficult urination. His PBR volume varied significantly from 74 milliliter to more than 500 milliliter, so indicating very large. Ultrasound echography showed a quasi-normal placid volume of 23 milliliters without protrusion of the inner gland, and his prostate-specific antigen was normal. However, cystoscopy revealed marked trabeculation suggestive of neurogenic etiology, so he was referred to us. No motor disorder. Urodynamic sphincter EMG revealed detrusor hyperactivity with impaired contraction that we called DHIC and the neurogenic changes of the sphincter motor unit potentials. He did not have DSD. While he had no cerebellar or Parkinsonism, he was revealed to have silent cerebellar hypoperfusion by brain spectral scan and slight cerebellar atrophy by brain MRI scan. Although he lacked a motor disorder, all these features suggested probable premotor MSA-C. We started him on clean intermittent catheterization. His urological, neurological, and neuroimaging findings did not change already for three years. But except for his bodily volume gradually decreased and he became complete retention, and he spoke a little bit an unclear voice, but not significant. This is the result of the upper panel, DHIC, bladder, and the lower panel, sphincter, and neurogenic changes. And this is the imaging. The right panel shows the slight atrophy of the cerebellum, and the left panel clearly shows the hyperperfusion by the ECD, perfusion spect. This is that scan is completely normal. In our country, the MSA-C is much more common than MSA-P. Interpretation: up to 18.2% of MSA patients might have bladder dysfunction alone. However, it seems difficult to diagnose such very early cases. Our case raises two issues. The first issue is that MSA patients who should not have urological surgery at a urology clinic for urologists. How to diagnose by urologists? The first step is the large PBR more than 100 milliliter without marked prostatic hyperplasia in men. And the urodynamics, I think urodynamics is necessary to seek the presence of DSIC. And also, sphincter EMG study is also necessary, I think. The sphincter EMG abnormality is very common in this disorder. The second issue is for such patients seek a final diagnosis, and it's an issue of us, neurologists. Initially, we have to exclude common neurological conditions such as lumbar spondylosis, diabetes, or spina bifida occulta, that all of these diseases may cause retention. How to diagnose the early MSA? I think it's a combination of neuroimaging such as FDG PET, MRI, and brain data scan or spectroscan. These are helpful and the best choice for diagnosing premotor MSA in situ. Conclusion: the present case report suggests that neuroimaging helps in the diagnosis of premotor MSA-C in situ. Thank you very much for your attention.